Alright, so the patch notes are here for the V770 update, and there's a couple things here that I really like, and a couple other things that have me really confused, in addition to one particular change that is coming to the game that has me thinking that someone from the Future Fight team is actually watching the videos. Not trying to toot my own horn or nothing, we'll get into it in a moment here, but we have the maintenance details right here before us, so expect the game to be going down for about 7 hours today. So make sure you get as much done as possible, because you're not going to be able to access the game for at least 7 hours, and anything can happen in that time. They could break the game basically, and it could take longer than that, so you don't want to miss out on your daily rewards. So here are the things that are coming in today's update. We got 4 new uniforms, which we already knew about, 2 for Spider-Man, 1 for Kingpin, and 1 for Black Cat. Kingpin is actually getting a tier 3, which is kind of surprising. I thought it was going to be an awakened skill, which was going to be shared by him and Black Cat since they were announced together. And apparently there's nothing for Black Cat. Shocking. I don't understand why, especially since, surprise, surprise, the uniform for Black Cat is actually going to be a paid uniform, just like all of the female characters before her. In addition to that, they're actually adding new sectors for dispatch missions, so that's really good. I'm looking forward to trying those out and seeing how difficult they are. I've actually been making some progress on the free-to-play account, which I wanted to share with you guys because I wanted to test out that account and see how far we can go. In addition to that, they're adding autoplay and auto-repeat to Dimension Rift, so that's pretty good. They're adding autoplay to a couple other game modes, including Alliance Battle, Normal Alliance Battle. No idea why they decided to do that instead of adding autoplay to story mode like they said they were going to, but I guess that might be taking them a little bit longer, so they wanted to put the autoplay in other pieces of content. And you know what, autoplay to Alliance Battle is actually a good start because of the fact that a lot of people out there don't even play normal Alliance Battle on a daily basis, so at least this will get their foot in the door. That way they can start getting some of the rewards that they're missing out on. We're also getting some new artifacts, which we expected, but that being said, let's jump into it, man. So over here you can see new uniforms added for Spider-Man, Kingpin, and Black Cat. Kingpin is getting his tier 3. That means Black Cat is not getting anything off rip. She's basically getting the Gwenpool treatment. She's going to have level 70, gear 25 possible, but she's not getting an awakened skill or a tier 3. That's kind of dumb, poor marketing. Why would you do that, especially considering the fact that this is a limited time uniform that you're not going to be able to buy until next year if you choose not to buy it. And anytime after that, they could easily give this character an awakened skill or a tier 3, just like they did for White Fox. Not too sure what's going on with these guys. Why on earth they wouldn't give Black Cat a tier 3 to ensure that people spend more money on the game, right? Because obviously that's what you want. If you're running a business, you want to give people as many reasons as possible to spend money. If you know you're going to make Black Cat's uniform cost money to get, why would you not give the character a tier 3 or an awakened skill right off the bat in order to make sure that she's good and available for all pieces of content so more people are inclined to buy her? Don't be stupid, Netmarble. This is not a good move. Anyways, moving on. So dispatch 11 and 12 available, auto repeat. Knew that. And then also they're making some changes to squad battle and giant boss raid. We'll talk about that once we get a little bit further in this video. So Spider-Man's uniforms are going to be Synergy's uniforms, and both of them are going to be on sale for 40% off. Black Cat's uniform is only going to be available in the token shop from buying stuff, and the Kingpin uniform will be sold for crystals, but it will not be on sale, so no discount at all. It's going to be like what, 1700 crystals. So moving on, let's talk about Spider-Man and his new uniforms that we're getting. Okay, so the new red suit for Spider-Man is offering him some decent changes. As you can see right here, it's increasing his critical rate, which is base critical rate, by 30%, and his dodge rate by 25%. The crit rate buff is nice. I don't really care about the dodge rate. This is way better than his previous uniform. And then in addition to that, excluding bosses, so in PvP game modes, Spider-Man will actually ignore enemies damage decrease effects by 50%. This is like the CTP of greed effect. More specifically, this is the ambush effect, or at least part of it, applied to Spider-Man. So you can see right here, for ambush, It ignores enemies' damage decrease effect by 35% on the Mighty, and then on the Brilliant, it actually ignores the enemy's damage decrease effect by 70%. You don't get this portion of the Greed effect, which is the 220% damage increase to all types, but you get to ignore their damage decrease effect. And that means if an enemy's running a CTP of Authority to get that damage decrease, Spider-Man's gonna cut through that like it doesn't exist. That is a big buff to Spider-Man's PvP potential. No lie, guys, this is gonna be amazing for him. And this is gonna be applied all the time, so that's gonna be amazing. Spider-Man is looking like he's gonna be a PvP god. Moving on, Spider-Man's tier 3 skill effect has actually been changed from all of his previous uniforms. So right off the bat, you'll notice that Spider-Man now has a web ability that ignores immunity. That means it will apply to World Boss Ultimates. So you'll be able to CC the World Boss Ultimates like Proxima, Midnight, Thanos before he puts up his debuff immunity and stuff. Call of City and Corvus, all those guys can now be CC'd by Spider-Man. This is an ability that we've been asking for a very, very long time. So it seems they're listening here. I'm not too sure why they're giving him ignore defense. That's kind of useless. They actually nerfed his ignore dodge from 40% to 25%, but they buffed the duration from 7 seconds, I believe, to 10 seconds. So that's pretty good. He has invincibility now for 10 seconds, which is amazing because he didn't have that at all before. And he can remove all debuffs for 10 seconds. That is also amazing, PvP wise, and also for PvE when you get hit with the Blade Twister or the Poison Meteor in World Boss Legend. He gets a 25% attack and defense buff for 30 seconds. That's actually not bad. Before, the attack buff here was only for 7 seconds and he did not get the extra defense. So that's pretty good. Moving on, Spider-Man has a new 4-star passive now. Before, it gave him stun immunity and snare immunity. They actually changed that to make it so that when his HP drops below 40%, he actually recovers 30% of his max HP for 1 second. This is on a 30 second cooldown, which is actually not that bad. And he also gains invisibility and he ignores targeting for 5 seconds. That is amazing. Okay, Spider-Man now has one of the best passives, 4-star passives in the game. So this passive right here is gonna bump up his usage in PvP big time. So shout out to Netmarble for actually giving Spider-Man an amazing 4-star passive. Moving on, his tier 2 passive is actually being changed from Great Responsibility, which initially gave him 25% guaranteed dodge and a 2-second increase to the duration of all his web abilities. That's being changed to 25% guaranteed dodge, which he already had. But here's the kicker. Now Spider-Man does 60% additional damage to all supervillain types. This is absolutely amazing. Spider-Man is going to be doing so much damage now. This is exactly what we wanted. If he's not meta after getting a heal, invisibility and an extra damage buff to supervillain, plus his tier 3 now giving him ignore dodge, invincibility. Oh my god, Spider-Man has so many amazing abilities now, and we're not even done yet, boys. So moving on, first skill, stun. Second skill, it does shock damage. That's fine, that's just basic stuff. But third skill, tumble dropkick, now gives him immunity, so that's great. And then on top of that, it's not the greatest amount of damage accumulation, but it's okay. Spider-Man now has damage accumulation for 8 seconds. It's a 12 second cooldown, so you can keep this up pretty much all the time. This is absolutely amazing. Okay, he's getting all the meta abilities that we wanted Spider-Man to get to possibly make him a top tier character. You love to see it. So Spider-Man now has a secondary web ability that actually ignores immunity, so you don't have to wait to get his tier 3 before you can start CCing world bosses, because Spider-Man is a CC demon. That's what he's been known for throughout his history in the comics, right? So it's nice to see that he can now web up world boss ultimate stages, but we're at World Boss Legend now. But for the memes, it's not bad to see you web up Proxima, Supergiant, and all those guys, okay? In addition to that, Spider-Man also heals on his 4th skill 20% of his max HP, and he has a 70% chance to penetrate everything for 5 seconds. That's amazing, especially considering this skill is on a 9-second cooldown. And it also has ignore iframe, so if an enemy is trying to hide in an iframe, Spider-Man's still gonna web him up. This is absolutely amazing. The fact that Spider-Man can heal 20% of his max HP every 4.5 seconds and ignore iframe and penetrate, like, he's literally gonna be able to penetrate all the time because this is a 5-second duration with a 9-second cooldown. This is probably gonna be even worse than Quicksilver. Oh my god, Spider-Man is actually a demon, boys. All right, so the 5th skill, you can actually move using the D-pad. That's actually pretty cool. And then in addition to that, Spider-Man has the most guard hit we've ever seen on any character, 20 guard hit. Usually guard hits are not that useful, but 20 guard hit, it can make a difference if the enemy doesn't have penetration. So yeah, Spider-Man looking pretty amazing, guys. Also has a damage proc gear for 100%. One thing I don't like about this skill is the 18 second cooldown. That's not very proc friendly. Ideally, you want at most 15 seconds. So you might, depending on which skill does the most damage. If this skill is the one that does the most damage, then he might not be the most proc friendly character. But if you can proc on this skill right here, or you can proc on the third skill, he might actually be really, really good with a regular damage proc. Moving on, let's take a look at Spider-Man's black suit and see the differences between them. So right off the bat, you'll notice that the black suit is not looking as good as the red one. So this one right here was making it so that you ignore enemies' damage decreased by 50%. So all those pesky heroes and villains that can take 50% less damage based off, I don't know, Colossus passive and whatnot, they can't hide from you with that. But this one right here doesn't have that. It just gives him critical rate and critical damage. But let's move on and let's see what else he gets. So the tier 3 still has the web immunity, still has the ignore defense, the ignore dodge, the invincibility. So it's pretty much the exact same thing. And the 4-star passive is pretty much exactly the same. The tier 2 passive is exactly the same. First skill the same, second skill the same. Third skill, it looks exactly the same. So what is the difference here? Oh, the difference now comes right here, boys. Mystic Mayhem. So Spider-Man actually has time freeze for 4 seconds on his fourth skill, and he can remove all debuffs from himself, and he has a 30% attack buff here. He can still penetrate everything for 5 seconds. He has debuff removal and a 30% attack buff. However, you can see right here that the fourth skill has a 12 second cooldown, which means you're not gonna be able to penetrate everything all the time with this uniform. And he also doesn't have ignore targeting that he did on the red suit. So the red suit is looking much better for PvE and PvP, frankly, than the black one. Because you can see right here, shorter cooldown time. You can keep the penetration up all the time. You can ignore target pretty much all the time, and you're still getting the heal. You're still able to CC. It's web versus time freeze, and you can also remove all active buffs from the target, so that's actually pretty good. And the fifth skill is pretty much the same with that really long gross cooldown time. Actually, the black suit just looks worse in general. I think the only reason to buy it is for the synergy bonus. Do keep in mind that when you buy one uniform, the price of the second uniform for Spider-Man is going to be discounted to, I believe, 630 crystals. But looking at the black suit and the red suit, I can honestly say that the black one, if you were only going to pick one, the black one looks like the one you should skip. Go with the red, guys. Moving on, we have Kingpin. So his uniform is going to be 1750, no discount, as you can see. However, his uniform is looking pretty spicy, boys. We have chain hit damage when he's attacking by 15%. And then when attacking, he has 100% chance to increase his critical damage by 45%. Rogue has something similar to this, so that's actually pretty good. It has a 7-second duration and a 10-second cooldown, so it's pretty much going to be up 70% of the time you're using Kingpin. They are changing his leadership, I believe. I'm not too sure why they said this is his ultimate skill, but this looks like his leadership, and it's very similar to what they just gave to Sif. It's actually exactly what I wanted to see for Kingpin, so he gets some physical attack, and he also gives HP as a leadership, so that's amazing. Okay, shout out to Netmarble for actually stepping out of their comfort zone and giving these combat characters some attack and HP, because that's honestly what they need. So criminal mastermind passive for Kingpin being changed from 5% physical attack, which is yikes, to now giving him 30% critical damage and ignore dodge by 45%. That is amazing. A massive buff there for him. It's gonna be amazing to use this guy in World Boss Legend. Moving on, his tier 2 passive now increases his guaranteed critical rate by 25%. So if you're using Kingpin with a CTP of Rage, he looks like he's going to be good, because he's not going to miss out on the ignore dodge or the chain hit damage. You can see he's getting that from his uniform. So it looks like they're prepping this guy to be using a CTP of Rage. Moving on, the first skill has Paralysis. So ABX, Kingpin might be making a return there, or at least AB, because ABX wasn't around when Kingpin was meta. Moving on, second skill is Stun. He heals himself for 15% of his max HP for 2 seconds, so that's 30%. And then he has a 6 guard hit. That's okay, I guess. Moving on, he deals burn damage. Again, another ABX ability. You love to see it. And then he's immune to damage for 3 seconds. 60-second cooldown. That is hella yikes. Oof. But it does have a 100% damage proc on there for 6 seconds. However, I don't like this long cooldown time, but like I said previously, it looks like they're prepping you to use him with a CTP of Rage. And when you're using the CTP of Rage, the cooldown on your skills, it doesn't really matter as much as if you're using a single damage proc. Moving on, we have burn again on one of KINGPIN's skills here, so that's pretty good. He has penetration. He can pretty much penetrate everything for 7 seconds, 18 second cooldown. So yeah, they're definitely setting him up to use a CTP of Rage because of the long cooldown here on his 4 and his 5. He increases all basic attacks, defense, and critical rate, 30% and 20% respectively, and he can actually remove incapacitation for 7 seconds. Honestly, KINGPIN looks really good. I like his leadership, I like his new 4-star passive, and I like his uniform bonus. So I'm actually looking forward to playing with him, and he looks like he has almost everything you need to be ABX meta. The only thing that's missing is silence. He has paralysis on his 1, and then he has burn on 2 different skills. So they might be doing something here, boys. You might not want to skip this one. We'll see how he does on the combat super villain day. Moving on, we have Black Cat, the character that is kind of getting shafted and shafting the player base at the exact same time. However, maybe that's coming in the mid-month patch. Hopefully the uniform is around for us to see what's coming in the mid-month patch. And if she is getting something there, there's enough time for you to buy something, get the tokens so you can buy the uniform for the character. Because as you can see, you're going to need 30 of these tokens. They might give away 10 for free, but you're definitely going to have to buy something. Now, moving on, her uniform bonus is absolutely amazing. Again, I don't understand why they didn't give this character a tier 3 or an awakened skill, because with this kind of uniform bonus, she very well could have been squad battle meta, ABX meta, and top tier for World Boss Legend. Just off this uniform bonus alone, 20% chain hit damage when attacking all the time, no cooldown, nothing. And then she has guaranteed critical rate, 35%, which preps her to use a CTP of Rage. And then she has critical damage as well. Moving on, villain allies all get a 65% all attack buff and a 35% ignore dodge buff. This tells me that she most definitely has to be getting a tier 3 or an awakened skill as a part of the mid-month pass, because ignore dodge isn't something we use outside of World Boss Legend very often. Yes, there's Corvus Glaive, but come on, man, we don't really be using ignore dodge leaderships against that guy like that. We want the attack and we want the ignore dodge because we want to clap cheeks against Null. So the fact that they're putting this here means they're prepping her for a tier 3 or an awakened skill, if not in the mid-month patch, by the end of the next year, which again, I don't understand why they would shaft themselves by not giving her a tier 3 or an awakened skill right off the bat to make sure that people understand her value. Anyways, moving on, her tier 2 passive has been changed. Now it decreases all buff effects by 80% and their duration by 50% for 10 seconds on a 15 second cooldown. Before, it was way weaker, so I'm liking this. This is gonna be a PvP ability. I don't think this is gonna apply in World Boss Legend, so do keep that in mind. In addition to that, she increases all allies, not just villain allies, but all allies debuff effects by 40%. This is PvP again, and then right here, she applies to herself, increased guaranteed dodge by 35%, and then skill damage and bonus damage. Before, a lot of her abilities were on a cooldown, so she didn't have them all the time. Now you can see that the majority of them are actually just there passively all the time, so that's gonna bump up her stock real nicely. Moving on, we have stun and bind. That's not really that great. However, we have bleed damage and paralysis here, so paralysis could be good for ABX. That's kind of the reason why. I'm kind of sad she's not getting a tier 3 or whatnot right off the bat. She also has silence. Again, this could be really, really useful. She could essentially be replacing Baron Zemo as a leadership for ABX. And if on top of that she got an awakened skill over that guy, you could have been doing like a triple swap where you're using Black Cat, Bullseye, and then Corvus Glaive, and that could possibly increase your score. Hopefully they actually see the potential to make some money here with the character. So anyway, she has invincibility and she removes all debuffs for 3 seconds, 13 second cooldown, really odd cooldown time there, but they might be prepping her for a rage. Again, 16 seconds here, again, definitely prepping her for a rage. Anyways, she has a 50% chance to penetrate everything. They forgot to put for how long, but it's a couple seconds, it's not all the time. And she's immune to all damage for 6 seconds, 16 second cooldown. Okay, so she gets a massive defense buff, a pretty good attack buff. It's very weird to see a character, especially a speed character, get more defense than attack in one of these abilities. Generally, it's the same amount of attack and defense. I'm not too sure why they decided to do it this way around. I would have preferred more attack, obviously, all the time. However, we have burn here. So she has burn, silence, and paralysis. So yeah, she's prepped to do ABX. Oh man, they gotta be mid-month tier 3-ing her. or something like that. Mid-month awaken skill for her. Gotta be. So they moved her healing off of her 4-star passive to now being on her 5th skill. It's fine. It's 20% flat all the time every 7 seconds. That's okay. And then she's getting another attack buff here and a crit rate buff. 14. Yeah, they have to be giving her a mid-month tier 3 down the road or something crazy like that, because it doesn't make sense why they would make her viable for every season of ABX. The silence, the paralysis, and the burn being there is just a dead giveaway to me. You guys let me know what you think in the comments. Moving on, we have KINGPIN's tier 3 here. I'll show you guys what the animation looks like, but KINGPIN was missing silence. He has paralysis and burn. However, on his tier 3 here, he actually gets silence at the very beginning of the skill. So he's prepped to do ABX for every season, which is really, really good. He has a 50% all attack buff, invincibility, and he has defense down that applies in World Boss Ultimate. It's not the strongest tier 3 skill, but he has everything you need for ABX, and that's something that I was very, very much looking forward to. So hopefully he's able to replace Apocalypse, for me at least. I don't know about for you guys, maybe you don't care about that. Moving on, this is what KINGPIN's tier 3 actually looks like here. So it's definitely the same ability that we saw in the trailer. I thought it was an awakened skill, but it's actually the tier 3. We didn't see everything, but it's definitely the same skill. Okay, so dispatch is here. Confront the problems that are happening in each sector. New sector 11 and 12 have been added. It's gonna be pretty much the same. You're gonna need a lot of attack and a lot of pierce. And right here, they're telling you that you can get CTP, Awakening ISOs, Premium Cards, Odin's Blessings, and other stuff. So starting from 11 and 12, you can also get Essence as the main supply reward. So it's gonna be the same thing. That kind of sucks. But I guess they wanna push the artifact system. And if you're getting free Essence from just collecting your boxes, I guess that won't be too bad. Now, 12-5 looks like it's gonna be a pain in the ass because of the fact that they're asking you to use a character that doesn't have a tier 3 or an awakened skill, which is Wen Wu, which means your damage is going to have to be on point if you wanna clear the stage and get all the nodes checked off. Let's see what else they got here for us. So autoplay plus and auto repeat has been added to Dimension Rift. That's completely fine. We knew that was coming. The autoplay feature has been added to normal. You can see right there the 10-minute timer going down. And then this is what I was talking about. So recently I made a video talking about how they could make Alliance Conquest better. And one of the features that I suggested to these guys was the ability to preset your teams to cut down some of the time that you need to invest into Alliance Conquest. So what they decided to do was actually add preset slots to Giant Boss Raid. You can now save your teams. You can now save your teams to make it so that the game mode goes by a little bit faster. That's pretty cool, and it looks like they're adding that exact same feature to squad battle as well. So as you can see right here, the team that you used that gave you the highest score in whatever league you're in is gonna be highlighted, is gonna be at the top, which is gonna make it so that you don't have to check which characters you used on the previous week. So that's pretty good. Let's move on and see what else they have to say here. So we're getting new artifacts for Spider-Man, KINGPIN, and Black Cat. And this is another indication that Black Cat has to be getting something. There's no reason for them to give an artifact to a normal tier 2 character. That's just the dumbest thing possible. And Black Cat is possibly getting the best one because it applies to all allies. So if you get this artifact and you put it on her and use her as a leadership for Extreme Alliance battle or squad battle, she's gonna make it so that your Corvus Glaive and your Bullseye does more damage. She's effectively replacing Baron Zemo. And what it does is, as you can see right here, it increases your damage dealt to supervillains by 10%, superheroes by 10%, and then boss types by 20%. I'm not too sure if these stack, meaning if you go up against Null in World Boss Legend, because he's a supervillain and a boss type, I'm not too sure if he's gonna be taking 30% extra damage. Hopefully that's how it works though, because that would be amazing. KINGPIN, as you can see right here, he's getting a 15% attack buff. It's kind of like whatever to me. It's not the greatest, but extra attack is not that bad. Moving on, Spider-Man, as you can see right here, he has a 20% chance to dodge all attacks. This seems rather useless to me because there's so many characters running a CDP of energy that gives you up to 40% ignore dodge. There's so many characters now that have abilities that give them ignore dodge, and some of them even have it passively. So a 20% chance to dodge all attacks when we have ignore dodge as a thing in the game. That's kind of stupid, unless this is going to work outside the parameters of ignore dodge, meaning this 20% chance to dodge incoming attacks does not get affected by ignore dodge. If that's the case, that would be amazing, but we'll have to wait and see, because otherwise this is the most useless artifact they could have given the guy. Might not be such a bad thing, because some of you guys were hoping that Spider-Man wouldn't get the Heimdall treatment, where the character for the most part is being shafted unless you have their artifact. Now moving on, we have a new season pass. No new characters in it because we're not getting any new characters, but we have special icons coming for Kingpin and Psylocke, my girl Baylock. Oh, and there's a new dance for Spider-Man, which looks pretty cool. I'm not even gonna cap. Okay, they're also finally adding the auto change feature for uniform options. That's actually pretty good. So now you can waste gold faster. Maybe they could have cut the gold from 50k to 25k. You can select multiple options. So you can have your main option and your backup option. So that's actually not that bad. Moving on. New character search filter has been added, so now you can search for upgradable heroes. So if you're just trying to figure out who do I want to waste gold and black antimatter CCF and all them stuff on today, you can go in and you can search for upgradable heroes, and then you can just upgrade a character randomly. Okay, so this is pretty important, so I want to highlight this for you guys. So previously, when you converted your ISOs, your obelisk, or your comic cards into boost items, you couldn't use them to upgrade your agent badge for your agent level. However, they're changing that to allow that to happen now. So that's actually really, really good, because there was no warning ahead of time that you could not actually use these items to feed into your agent level. So some people converted hundreds and they were not able to use them after the fact. So that's pretty cool as well. They've also made a couple other changes here, like a buff to the Timeline Survival shop to show the remaining items. However, Timeline Survival is just not a good time investment in my personal opinion, so I don't play it, but if you play it, I guess that's good for you. They've also fixed a couple other bugs, one for Cable being able to knock back Mephisto and World Boss Legend, and then one where Deadpool on his anniversary uniform, it was not displaying all of the explosions on his third skill. There's also a bug where the immunity to guard break was not being shown for Hela and Wolverine's artifact. It's kind of a bummer that Hela is not getting a buff to her third skill to include iframe ignore, but it is what it is. Hela is plenty powerful already, so I'm not gonna complain about that. Anyways guys, we're gonna wrap it up right here. Thank you so much for watching. Leave me your thoughts on the patch notes, how you guys feel about it overall, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.